Reverend Oksu Park has devoted himself to reach the youth all over the world to guide them to become the leaders of the next generation. His message has brought many people out of pain and darkness and into lives of darkness and brightness and joy. Reverend Oksu Park says that the secret to the new strength and happy life that he teaches comes from the pathways of the heart he discovered in the Bible. After receiving land from the Zambian government for mine education in 2016, Reverend Oksu Park had started the construction of the IYF Center. In March 2016, an FA agreement for youth education was signed with the government of Vietnam. Furthermore, since 2018, the IYF has been conducting mine education for the drug addicts and as well as the victims of rebel groups in Colombia. In addition to such amazing activities, the inauguration ceremony for a three-year mine education program from 2019 to 2021 for the government and education officials in the Ivory Coast was recently held. Many presidents, prime ministers, and government ministers are continually arranging meetings with Reverend Oksu Park and provide generous support for the youth empowerment initiative. So far, mind education is being actively implemented via MOU agreements with 450 organizations in 95 countries around the world. Christian Leaders Fellowship has recently created a wind of change in the world of Christianity. Representative church pastors of various denominations, including the presence of Christian associations from the North and South America, Africa, and Asia, gathered to unite their focus on delivering the gospel based on the Bible only by going beyond denominational and doctrinal terms. Through the CLF being held worldwide since 2017, more than 240,000 pastors have heard the gospel and are examining their spiritual lives. The main speaker of the CLF, Reverend Oksu Park, warms up the hearts of the world Christian leaders and inspires them with the message, "Let's go back to the Bible," as he delivers lectures on the Bible. The CLF was held in Seoul, Korea, celebrating the 500th anniversary of Martin Luther's Reformation. During the second half of 2017, pastors from around the world cried out, "Let's go back to the Bible," at the CLF alongside the Bible seminar with Reverend Oksu Park in May 2018. With the participation of over 500 representative bishops from around the world, including Kisef Arthur Gitunga and Gafrida Nsindiluka, the Zambia Minister of Religious Affairs. The symposium was held with the theme, "The True Gospel and Spiritual Life." Furthermore, the joint press conference of the global Christian leaders has caught the attention of the media. As a result of these activities came the global online Bible seminar preaching the gospel to 94 countries over 2015 broadcasting stations in 26 different languages to 800 million viewers across the world. Pastors who called for change and reform to Christianity on its decline created a movement to only focus on the Bible and to unite our hearts with God to preach only the gospel. Now, many Christian denominations of various countries are fully supporting and taking part in this ministry to preach the precise gospel alongside Reverend Oksu Park. Currently, Reverend Oksu Park is responsible for 67 publications consisting of a Christian and mind education literature with the purpose of manifesting the heart of God to people. Among them, his best-selling book titled How I Became Free from Sin and sold over 1 million copies and was translated into 24 different languages. This book speaks on true repentance and the gospel, which provides the forgiveness of sins to those who were once bound in sin. It also teaches about the true pastorship and spiritual life worldwide, freeing many people theory or formality. Finally, it shows that spiritual life is not of works or labor, but only by grace and faith. Hello everyone. Pastor Oksu Park's online Bible post seminar with 94 countries. Let us sing together. Hymnal page 194. Oops, 193.
그대는 시키어 있는가 더러운 죄이게 하는 능력을 그대는 참으시 하는가 예수의 보혈로 그대는 씻기어 있는가 마음속에 여러가지 죄악이 깨끗이 씻기어 있는가 주 예수와 밤낮으로 늘 함께 그대는 행동을 하는가 아무 때나 어디든지 그대는 십자가 붙들고 있는가 예수의 보혈로 그대는 씻기어 있는가 마음속에 여러가지 죄악이 깨끗이 씻기어 있는가 주님 예수 다시 올 때 그대는 영접할 예복이 있는가 그대 몸은 거룩한 곳 성전에 들어갈 준비가 됐는가 예수의 솟아나는 보혈로 눈보다 더 이게 씻으라 예수의 보혈로 그대는 씻기어 있는가 마음속에 여러가지 죄악이 깨끗이 씻기어 있는가
495장을 부르겠습니다.
내 영혼이 은총이어 중한 죄짐 벗고 보니 슬픔 많은 이 세상도
last week, from last Sunday, we had a Bible seminar in 94 countries. About 800 million viewers, we had this seminar. And so many people with the testimonies, with comments, they reply to us. The just touching moment felt by these comments and testimony, we cannot even forget them. When I think about it, I'm so thankful. I give great glory and praises to God. So continuing, I'm so thankful then we are able to be here with you. So today and until the day after tomorrow, the word of God being preached, I believe that it will change our lives. So I give thanks to God. And Pastor Changnyeong Kim from Good News Gangnam Church will come out and pray. Dear Father God, we thank you. There was many crises in the world because of the coronavirus. We also suffered. But through the medium called the media and internet, you are able to preach the gospel. You had opened the way for us. When we had the Easter service online, we didn't know what outcome we will have. But 2 million people attended, and also with 6 million viewers, they're together with the Easter service. They say how they came to put down themselves and how they became holy. So we, even just within the South America, 4,000 people commented, and we believe that there are many more. The online Bible seminar that started on May 10th within 94 countries and 205 broadcasting stations, it was broadcast to 800 million viewers. We have such a great thankfulness. We have indescribable joy and gladness. The word being preached through your servant, it changed people's lives. We are continually hearing these testimonies of people being sanctified, justified. The word in Hebrews that we became justified was just simple. What was really complicated and complex and people who are bound by the law, through this simple gospel, they receive salvation. They show thankfulness. They are so thankful to be able to hear the word of the pastor. Father God, just as your word in this last age, you have opened this vast door. You have opened the door of the gospel before us. There are problems in the world, but despite that, you're doing great work in us. We give thankfulness and glory to you. In the beginning, because of the coronavirus, we had difficulties in our hearts. And Apostle Paul went to Rome. He met this in a storm. The ship almost wrecked. When he arrived at this island, he was bitten by a viper. But after that, there was great work of 330,000 people receiving salvation. Through this Bible seminar, this gospel was preached to 800 million people. It's like more than one-tenth of the population, they got a chance to hear the gospel. We are so joyful and thankful. And in many countries, they express that they want to hear the word more. So from today, tomorrow, and the day after tomorrow, for 3 days, we have this online post-seminar. Through this post-seminar, the word that will be preached, not only will they justify and sanctify people's hearts, we believe that they will also allow them to live the spiritual life. Please hold on to your servant. So then let him preach the word powerfully. Let this be a precious hour. We give thanks to you, Lord. In the name of Jesus, I prayed. Amen. In the past week, we at Bible seminar, it caught the attention of the world. In total of 215 broadcasting stations, it was broadcast. And many people were together with us. Apostle Paul, as he went the witnessing trip, he preached the gospel. And then before that, many gospel preachers, they will go to the big auditorium with people and preach the gospel. But now, God has worked amazingly. We are in the same place. But worldwide, over 800 million people through different means, when we see how the gospel is being preached, it is so amazing. We could see how miraculously God is doing the work. The Bible seminar this week, this is May 20th, Wednesday. It is 7:30 in Korean time. Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday for 3 days, this seminar continues. You can search Good News TV on YouTube. When people who search YouTube on overseas, you may type in Good News TV Global and have access to the word. When the word is preached, the sermon that is recorded, we post that on the Good News TV Global. Even though you may not listen to the word now, if you want to listen to the word again, through this channel, you are able to listen to it again. Among the books written by the main speaker, Repentance and Faith, How Should I Believe God, How I Became Free from Sin, and many more spiritual books. The major online bookstores in Korea, also Amazon in the US, through many online bookstores, you may purchase them. Especially, How I Became Free from Sin, this book was translated into 24 languages. It is a million-seller book. Among the Christian literature, it is the best-seller. Many read the book, received the forgiveness of sin, and became free from sin. And there are many testimonies. I encourage you to purchase and read. The seminar last week, this ABC broadcast station in the U.S., and the largest Spanish Christian broadcasting station, Enlace broadcasting station, and TBN España in Europe. So through many media, and this was broadcasted from 94 countries and 215 broadcasting stations. They broadcasted this. So on Facebook, on YouTube, it was also broadcasted. It was translated into 26 languages. Within in Korea, there are about over 170 articles on this seminar, so we caught this attention. Even this week, we truly look forward to the seminar, and we are really thankful to hear what the word will be preached through the pastor at this time. We will have the greetings from the pastors abroad. And we will also hear the news. The president of India Bethel Baptist Association, Pastor Luther Chatler, we also have the news from the Central and South America.
I am Reverend Luther Chatler, the Vice President of Baptist India Ministries, greeting you from Vijayawada, Andhra Pradesh, India. I welcome you one and all for this grand Bible conference. I'm so excited. I thank God for this opportunity. The question that may come up is, why should I be part of this grand Bible conference? In short, I want to give you three blessings. At first, we are going to listen to a powerful man of God. Here is a man who is used by God, not only in his country, but across the globe. Can you believe that in his lifetime, he has sent missionaries from his church to nearly 100 countries? He planted thousands of churches across the globe. He met the leaders of the nation with the word of the God, word of Lord. And he is a man with passion. I have heard him several times, his preaching, his exposition on salvation, his preaching on the privileges we have in the new covenant. So we are going to be blessed by his preaching. Secondly, we are going to be in fellowship with people of God from around the globe. We are going to have fellowship with people from Asia, Africa, Europe, Australia, North America, South America, and Antarctica. I'm so excited. I think it's going to be a small kingdom of God on the earth. It is a privilege, it is a blessing to be with the people of God in this manner. And finally, you don't need to go anywhere. Prepare yourself, set yourself, and give yourself to the preaching. So So this is an opportunity, maybe once in a lifetime. I pray that God is going to empower and equip each and every one of us so that we may be a blessing to the people and the churches that we are serving. Friends, we are in a deep crisis. The heads of the nations are struggling. The scientists and the researchers are finding it difficult to find a medicine for the pandemic. The economists are struggling, are grappling with issues to revive the finances. At this point of time, we as the pastors and leaders, we need to bridge the gap between the crisis and God. And God is going to use us, He will empower us so that we may share the love, the hope in Christ, and the peace to the people who are in fear, who are in anxiety, that they may be blessed, they may be empowered, and they may have the faith for tomorrow. May God bless us through this conference. Amen.
Por las acciones que están emprendiendo en este Congreso Internacional.
Quiero invitarles a que ustedes formen parte de este gran esfuerzo que la Misión Buenas Nuevas está haciendo a través de la cadena internacional Enlace.
Estamos agradecidos con Dios por el privilegio que nos ha dado de poder relacionarnos con un ministerio tan importante a nivel internacional. Desde que empezamos a transmitir hace muchos años estudios del pastor Oxo Park, como fue el estudio del libro del Génesis, la relación que hemos mantenido a partir de ahí, ha sido muy linda.
Aunque yo bailara 100 o 1000 veces, considero que no sería suficiente. Incluso si agradeciera 1000 o 10.000 veces, seguiría siendo insuficiente. Sin importar lo que yo intentara, no podría pagar esa gracia. Incluso me pregunto si Dios se acordará de un hombre como yo. Pero Él limpió todos nuestros pecados. Y yo deseo anunciar esta verdad en todo el mundo. Porque perdonaré la maldad de ellos. Y no me acordaré más de su pecado. Dice Jehová. Amén.
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 Y cuando llegó el coronavirus a nuestro país, me entró el temor de morir. Perdonado en la cruz y de una vez y para siempre he alabado a Dios y le he dado la gloria.
Entonces, ¿cuántas veces usted y yo no hemos enseñado esto? Pero lo habíamos malinterpretado. Déjenme decirles, hermanos, dice que nunca más se acordará de esto. Nunca se acordará, nunca y nunca, hermanos. Él se vuelve a acordar de nuestros pecados.
We'll be right back.
여러분 한 번 더 볼까요? 여러분 유튜브 들어가셔서
You may go on YouTube and watch it again. Then it'll be great. As we watch again,
가슴이 뜨거워지고 이렇게 hearts were very hot.
And this precious work of the word of the gospel,
흘려 이렇게 전해지고
it is
퍼져서
preached to us and spread. And many people are also receiving salvation now on the internet. The sermons from the past week are uploaded. The online media, other broadcasting stations that started late,
there's
continually works of people receiving salvation 24 hours.
I give
glory and praises to God. The praise and glory, the Gracious Choir will give glory to God with their praises. We will listen to them.
Oh,
Thank you. The Gracious Choir give praises for the gospel. They are the world's best choir. As they go around the world, wherever the gospel is preached, they go and give glory to God. At this time, we will have time to listen to the word. The founder of Good News Mission, Pastor Spa, will come out and preach us the word.
I'm so thankful that we can gather again and speak about the words of the Bible.
미국에서 저 뭐야 박방원 목사님 오셨는데.
So Pastor Joseph Park, Park Bangwon came from America.
지금 안타깝게도 감금돼 있습니다.
Unfortunately, he is taken in quarantine.
얼마나 수고하는지 모르겠습니다.
And so he's going through a lot right now.
이번 그 주일날 오후에 오신답니다.
So I hear that he's coming out actually this Sunday afternoon.
감사한지 모르겠습니다.
I'm very thankful.
와서 이제 저희들이 이번 그 마친 뒤에
많은 방송 연락이 와서까지 앞으로 방송 설교를 정기적으로 해야 할 그런 위치에 있는데.
And so after this was over, actually, a lot of the broadcasting stations contacted us and they wanted to do continuous runs.
이제 그 박방원 목사의 후속 통역자로 이렇게 온다 그럽니다.
And so Pastor Park Bang-won, he will be here and he will continue to translate for us later on.
상당히 좋지만 않지만 안치도 않는 것 같습니다.
And so I think that is good, but also I don't think it's so good.
왜냐하면
because
그래서 기도 좀 많이 해야 할 같지만 같으니까요.
I think that we have to pray a lot actually for this.
모든 일에 하나님이 저희들 은혜를 베푸실 줄 믿습니다.
And I believe that God will bestow His grace in everything that we do.
오늘 저녁에는 출애굽기 제 12장의 말씀을 읽겠습니다.
Let's look at the words of Exodus chapter 12.
1절부터 읽겠습니다.
We'll read from verse 1.
출애굽기 12장 1절입니다.
Exodus chapter 12 from verse 1.
찾으셨으면 제가 읽겠습니다.
If you found it, I'll be in reading.
여호와께서 애굽 땅에서 모세와 아론에게 일러 가라사대.
And the Lord spake unto Moses and Aaron in the land of Egypt, saying,
이 달은 너에게 달의 시작 곧 해의 첫 달이 되게 하고.
This month shall be unto you the beginning of months; it shall be the first month of the year to you.
너희는 이스라엘 회중의 고아에 이르라 이달 열흘에 너희 매인이 어린 양을 취할지니 각 가족들 그 식구에 어린 양을 취하되.
Speak ye unto all the congregation of Israel, saying, In the tenth day of the month, they shall take unto every man a lamb according to the house of their father, a lamb for an house.
그 어린 양에 대해 식구가 너무 적으면 그 이 집의 이웃과 함께 인수를 따라서 하나를 취할 것이며 각 사는 식량을 따라 너희 양을 계산할 것이며.
And if the household be too little for the lamb, let him and also his neighbor next unto his house take it according to the number of the souls. Every man according to his eating shall take your count for the lamb.
너희 어린 양은 허무 없고 1년 된 수컷으로 하되 양이나 염소 중에서 취하고.
And your lamb shall be without blemish, a male the first year. You shall take it out of the sheep or from the goats.
이달 14일까지 간직하였다 해질 때 이스라엘 회중이 그 양을 잡고.
And you shall keep it up until the 14th day of the same month, and the whole assembly of the congregation of Israel shall kill it in the evening.
그 피로 양을 먹을 집문 좌우 설주와 임방에 바르고.
And thou shalt take the blood and strike it upon the two side posts and on the upper door posts of the houses wherein they shall eat it.
그 밤에 그 고기를 불에 구워 무경의 쓴나물 아울러 먹되.
And they shall eat the flesh in that night, roast with fire, unleavened bread, and with bitter herbs they shall eat it.
날로나 물에 싼 맛을 먹지 말고 머리와 내장, 정갈과 내장 다 불에 구워 먹고.
Eat not of it raw nor sodden with the water, but roast with fire his head and his legs and with the pertinence thereof.
아침까지 남겨두지 말지며 두지 말며 아침까지 남은 것 곧 소화하라.
And thou shalt not leave nothing of it remain until the morning, and that which remaineth until the morning ye shall burn with fire.
너희는 그것을 이렇게 먹을지니 허리에 띠를 띠고 발에 신을 신고 손에 지팡이를 잡고 피 먹으라. 이것이 여호와의 유월절이니라.
And thou shalt ye eat it with your loins girded and your shoes on your feet and your staff in your hand. Ye shall eat it with haste, and this is the Lord's Passover.
내가 그 밤에 애굽 땅에 두루 다니며 사람과 짐승을 물어나고 애굽 나라 가운데 처음 낭을 다 치고 애굽 모든 신에게 벌을 내리 나는 여호와로라.
For I will pass the land of Egypt this night and smite all the firstborn of the land of Egypt, both man and beast, and against all the gods in Egypt I will execute judgment. I am the Lord.
13절 한 절 더 읽겠습니다.
Verse 13.
13절.
Verse 13.
내가 애굽 땅을 칠 때에 그 피가 너희 가는 집에 있어서 너희를 위하여 표적이 될지라. 내가 피를 볼 때 너희를 넘어가리니 재앙이 너희에게 내려 멸하지 아니하리라.
And the blood shall be for you a token upon the houses where ye are. And when I see the blood, I shall pass over you. And the plague shall not be upon you to destroy you when I smite the land of Egypt.
죄송합니다. 제가 그 방송실에 저 자막하는 자매님께 13절까지 얘기하는데 12절 제가 말을 잘못해요. 자매 잘못된 것 같습니다.
So I told the sister that's in charge of the subtitles originally up to verse 12, but actually it was up to 13, so I made a mistake.
여러분 우리가 그 신앙생활 하면서 제 마음에 가장 즐거운 게 뭐냐 하고 물으시면
So everyone, as we live our spiritual life, if you ask me what's the most joyful thing?
출애굽기 12장 2절입니다.
It's the words of Exodus chapter 12 verse 2.
이달은 너에게 달의 시작 곧 해의 첫 달이 되게 하고.
This month shall be unto you the beginning of months, it shall be the first month of the year to you.
저는 제가 1962년도 구원을 받고 제 삶을 받기 전에
And before I received salvation, 1962,
내 삶이 너무 어둡고 추하고 정말 악했습니다.
My life was very dark. It was very filthy and also evil.
하, 나 왜 이런 인간으로 태어났지?
I thought, why was I born like this?
아, 나 정말 나란 인생이 너무 싫었습니다.
And I really hated myself.
근데 이 성경을 읽어 보니까 이달로 너에게 달의 시작곧 해의 첫 달이 되게 하고.
However, if you look at verse 2, it says, "This month shall be unto you the beginning of months; it shall be the first month unto the year to you."
그게 뭐 5월 달인지 10월 달인지 3월 달 잘 모르지만은.
And so I'm not exactly sure whether it's of May or of March or what month it may be.
이달로 너에게 달의 시작 곧 해의 첫 달이 되게 한다.
It says, "This shall be the beginning of months; it shall be the first month of the year to you."
그러니까 이제 예를 들어서 지금 현재 달이 8월 달이라고 합시다.
Let's say for example right now it's August.
근데 이 달로 너에게 달의 시작 해 첫 달이 된다면은
But they say that this month shall be the beginning of months, it shall be the first month to you.
지금까지 8월 달까지 살아온 그건 다 무효로 간다는 얘기죠.
Then that means that all the months up until August it goes to nothing.
하, 전 막 이야기 들을 때 너무너무 행복했어요.
And so when I heard these words, I felt so happy.
내가 지금까지 살아온 내 인생은 너무 추하고 더럽고 부끄럽고 악했기 때문에.
Because the life which I lived up until that point, it was so dark and dirty and filthy.
이달은 너에게 달이 시작과 해철 달이 된다면.
And if this shall be the first month to you, in the beginning of months.
그게 뭐 달이든지 전혀 상관없이.
It doesn't matter what month that may be.
이제 다시 시작하는 것부터 내 인생을 계산하겠다는 거죠.
They're saying that it will count my life starting from that month.
아, 이제 내가 시작이구나.
Ah, this is the beginning of my life.
그동안 내가 살았던 거 다 무효구나.
And everything which I lived up until that point, it's all nothing.
내가 그동안 악을 저질렀던 거.
All the evil which I committed.
더러웠던 거.
The dirty things of me.
추했던 거.
The filthy things of me.
욕망 속에 살았던 거.
And the me that lived inside of all this ambition.
아, 이거 전부 다 무효로 돌리는구나.
All these things will be turned to nothing.
여러분 저는 그때 내가 너무 싫었습니다.
And at that time, everyone, I truly hated myself.
한 번씩 거울을 쳐다보면,
from time to time, when I look at the mirror,
이렇게 나쁜 놈이 있나?
I think, oh, is there anyone as bad as I am?
마곡수의 악한 놈, 더러운 놈아! 막 외치고 싶었어.
I wanted to shout at myself, saying, Oksu Park, you dirty, evil man.
전 정말 제가 싫고. 싫고 싫었어요.
And I truly hated myself and hated myself and hated myself.
인물도 못생기고 키도 적고 잘나지도 못했는데.
Because I was not good looking, nor was I tall, nor was I good at anything.
근데 무엇보다도 제 마음이 너무 더럽고 추했어요.
But more than anything, my heart was so dirty and filthy.
자주 제가 거울을 보면 나쁜 놈 자식.
Oftentimes I would look at the mirror and say, "You evil man,
자식,
you such dirty man."
더러운 놈아 하고 막 소리 지르고 싶고 그랬어.
And I wanted to shout at myself, saying, "You filthy man."
근데 여러분 성경은 나 같은 인간에게 꼭 필요한 게 성경이에요.
But everyone, the Bible is something that is needed for somebody like me.
나 정말 더럽고 악한 인간인데.
Truly, I'm such a dirty, filthy human being.
나 정말 지긋지긋한 인간인데.
Truly, I'm such a sick and tired human being.
이달로 너에게 해의 달 첫 달이 되게 하고.
But it's saying that this shall be the first of months unto you.
그러니까 이제 이게 만일 9월 달이라면.
Let's say that it's September right now.
9월 달까지 살았던 거 다 무효로 해준다.
And that means that all the time that you lived up until September, it becomes nothing.
네가 새로운 삶을 살게 된다.
That means that you're able to live a new life.
야 진짜 그렇다면.
If that is truly the case.
얼마나 좋을까.
Then everyone, how great would that be?
그 더러운 죄.
All those dirty sins. 아, The evil.
그 더러움 진짜 거기서 내가 해방하고 새로 내 인생을 시작하는구나.
The filth. I'm able to throw all that away. I'm able to start my life anew.
그리고 이제 올해가 2020년이 됐어요.
And then now it's 2020.
우리가 이제 그 부활절 행사를 했습니다.
Everyone, we had the Easter event.
이제 그 코로나 때문에 이제 전부 다 모이지 못하도록 정부에서 얘기를 해서
So the government told us that we cannot have large gatherings because of the coronavirus.
저희들이 줌으로 이제 예배를 드리는데
So we had our services through Zoom.
이제 우리가 부활절 예배를 드리기로 했어요.
So we decided to have our Easter service.
이제 줌으로 부활절 예배를 시작했습니다. 새벽하고 오전하고 저녁하고
And so we decided to have our Easter service through Zoom for the early morning, morning and evening.
근데 부활절 그 예배를 시작하는데 진행자들 중간에 이 막 주님이 마비가 됐다.
But as we started our early morning service for the Easter Sunday, all of a sudden our pastors told me that right now there is
너무 많이 들어왔어.
The system froze because there's too many people that logged in.
얼마나 들어왔길래 물어봤어.
And I asked how many people logged in.
200만 명이 들어왔답니다.
They said 2 million people logged in.
뭐라고?
I said what?
2만 명 아니고
not 20,000?
200만 명이라는 거예요.
You're saying 2 million.
이해가 안 갔어요.
And so I couldn't understand.
점심 때도 그랬고.
It was like that for lunch.
저녁 때도 그랬고.
And it was that also for the evening.
진흥부에서 일한 목사님 막 감격해하더라고요.
And our pastors who were in charge of this, they were so touched by this.
인터넷 들어가 보니까
when going into the internet,
참 막 감사한 말들이 많이 올랐어요.
There were so many thankful remarks.
그리고 난 뒤에 그 부활절이 끝난 뒤에
and so after the Easter was over
부활절 우리가 다섯 개 언어로 이제 방송을 했는데
so we did the broadcast in 5 different languages
한국어, 영어, 중국어, 그다음에 에스파뇰 그리고 불어 다섯 개
and so it was in Korean, English, Chinese and Spanish and French
그리고 난 뒤에 그 에스파뇰 그 번역 통역한 이찬미 자매님이
So then the sister who was translating for the Spanish sister, Ichanmi told me.
이제가 말씀 마쳐갈 때쯤 돼서.
Around the time when the sermon was about to finish.
구원을 받았던 사람들이 막 간증이 올라오기 시작하는.
There are many testimonies of people who got saved.
3천 개까지 세리다가 말았다.
She was counting up to 3,000 and then she stopped.
아, 세릴 수가 없었어.
It just continued to come up and she couldn't count any longer.
나중에 에스파뇰 가운데서 에스파뇰 언어 가운데서. 제사로 확실히 받은 3천 명이라 그러네.
And they said that among the people that receive Spanish through the Spanish, through salvation through the Spanish, they said that it's 3,000 people.
실제로 그 언어 가운데 가장 적은 인구 에스파뇰인데요.
And so amongst all the other languages, actually those are the few, Spanish is the fewest.
여러분 저희들이 정말 깜짝 놀랐어요.
And we were so shocked.
그리고 난 뒤에 우리가 집회를 했습니다.
And then afterwards we had the seminar.
그래서 이제 많은 나라에서 이제 그 코로나 때문에 사람들이 밖에 다니지 못 안에 있으니까 어렵고 그런데
And so many people because of the coronavirus they couldn't go outside and they have to stay inside.
우리는 코로나 고생하는 사람들을 마음에 위로를 하기 위하여 이런 말씀을 가지고 이야기하고 싶었어.
So we wanted to comfort a lot of the people that were going through difficulty because of coronavirus through the word.
근데 사실 방송국 측에서 그때 뭐 경기도 없었고 다음에 공연도 없었고 막 그런 게 없으니까
And so at the time from all the broadcasting stations there are no sports matches there's no concerts nothing
거의 대부분의 방송들이 방송국이 우리 이 예배를 중계해 주기를 한
So majority of the broadcasting stations decided to air our event.
그래서 저희들이 이제 시작하는 날 형제가 말하기를 1억 한 3천쯤 얘기를 한 1억 3천이나 그랬어요.
And so when we first started our event, one of the brothers in charge, they said we were expecting around 130 million. I said, 130 million?
믿을 수가 없었어요.
I couldn't believe it.
어떻게 1억 3천 말도 안 돼.
I said 130 million, no way.
근데 계속해서 방송이 2억, 3억, 4억.
And then it continued to go up 200 million, 300 million, 400 million.
정말 이거 믿어도 좋아?
And I thought, really, is this believable?
아, 사실이 그렇다는 거야.
They said it's true.
8억이 훨씬 넘어 9억까지 올라갔다고.
And it was way over 800 million, and then it went all the way up to even 900 million.
그냥 저는 너무너무 행복하고 행복했어요.
Everyone, I was so happy and happy.
저 아무것도 아닌데 갑자기 막 유명인이 된 것 같은 기분이 들고요.
And so actually, I'm nothing, but I became almost like a very famous person.
그러자 많은 그 방송사에 저하고 인터뷰하자 그러고 신문사에서 인터뷰하자 그러고.
And so many of the broadcasting stations they wanted to have interview with me. Even newspapers they wanted to have interviews.
이런 거 하면 내가 이제 진정한 내 마음 있는 이야기를 할 수가 있었어요.
And so through these ways, I was able to really express my true heart.
여러분 하나님은 어떤 분이 하나님이시냐 하면은
Everyone, who is God?
하나님은 인간이 아니십니다.
God is not man.
만일 여러분 하나님 우리처럼 좁은 인간이라면
Let's say that God is a narrow man like us.
우리가 영원한 멸망을 다 받았을 텐데
Then we should have received this eternal destruction.
하나님 우리를 구원하시기 위하여 온 마음을 쏟는 분입니다.
However, God is the one who pours all of his heart to save us.
근데 이제 문제가 뭐냐면 하나님 우리를 참 구원하시게 구원의 길을 열어놨는데
However, the problem is that even though God opened up the way of salvation, he wants to save us.
하나님이 처음에 인간을 만들어 아담에게 선악을 하여 나무 열매를 먹지 말라 그랬어.
First, God created Adam and Eve, and then He said, "Do not eat of the fruit of knowledge, good and evil."
동산에는 모든 나무 실과 네가 마음대로 뜯어 따먹어도 돼.
You can eat of any of the fruits that are of the tree of the Garden of Eden.
그러나 선악을 알게 나면 그 열매를 먹지 마. 그 열매 먹으면 죽게 된다 그랬어.
But you shall not eat of the fruit of the fruit of knowledge good and evil. On the day that you eat of it, you shall surely die.
불행하게도 우리 조상 아담은 뱀에게 속아서.
Unfortunately, our forefather Adam, he was deceived by the serpent.
아니야, 네가 먹으면 죽지 않아.
Oh, Adam, even though you eat it, you're not going to die.
네 눈이 밝아져도 하나님처럼 될 거야.
Your eyes shall be open, and it shall be like God.
아담은 하나님처럼 되고 싶었습니다.
Adam wanted to become like God.
그 유혹에 빠져 선악을 알게 나무 열매를 먹었습니다.
He fell into that temptation and he ate the fruit of knowledge good and evil.
그러니 아담이 선과 악을 구별할 줄 아는 지혜를 얻었습니다.
And then Adam received the wisdom to be able to distinguish what's good and what's evil.
그래 하나님이 길 아니라도 자기 선과 악을 구분하니까.
And so even though it was not through God, but he can distinguish what's good and evil.
그 지혜로 가지고 하나님하고 다른 길을 아담이 걸어갈 수 있도록 길을 열었어요.
Therefore, it opened up the way for him to walk a different path other than God.
자 이제 우리가 그런 인간을 한 구원하시려고 애를 쓰시는데.
So God, he labored to be able to save people like us.
예, 우리가 구원을 받게 우리는 일부분만 알지 다 모든 걸 모르니까.
In terms of salvation, we only know a section of it. We don't know the entirety.
하나님 하신 말씀 그대로 우리가 믿음을 받아들이면 아무 문제가 안 되는데.
If we're able to believe and accept exactly what the word of God tells us, it's not a problem.
이제 인간들은 악한 영에 이끌림받고 그 지혜를 가지고.
However, man is being deceived by the evil Satan, and with that wisdom,
자기가 절망으로 가고 있지만 절망으로 가는 깨닫지만 절망으로 계속 가고 있는 거예요.
Even though he's walking into despair, he has no idea that he is, and he keeps going that way.
그래서 이제 하나님은 우리 인간들을 산에 그래서 건져내기 위하여.
Therefore, because God loved us, he wanted to save us out from that.
구원의 길을 만들고.
He made the way of salvation.
우리 이끌어가는 거예요.
And he leads us.
근데 우리가 우리 생각을 다 버리고 하나님 말씀 그대로 받아들여서 길을 걸어가면.
But everyone, if we throw away all of our thoughts and accept the word of God and walk that path.
저는 오늘 저에게 말씀 전하기 전 여러분들에게 하고 싶은 이야기가 있어요.
So before I preach the words to you this evening, there's something I want to tell you.
저는 성경에서 우리가 정말 죄에서 구원받는 귀한 방법을 많은 것을 보았어요.
I was able to see many precious ways on how to receive salvation through the Bible.
근데 대부분 사람은 하나님을 믿는다고 하지만.
Majority people say that they believe God.
성경을 읽기는 읽어요.
Even though they read the Bible.
근데 성경을 읽는데.
They read the Bible.
사람들이 두 가지 영이 있는데.
And people have two spirits.
하나 하나님의 영이고.
One is the spirit of God.
하나 악한 영이에요.
And the other is the evil spirit.
그래서 우리가 하나님의 성령의 이끌림을 받으면
if we're led by the Holy Spirit of God,
성경을 읽을 때 하나님과 같은 마음으로 흘러가게 돼 있어요.
Then when we read the Bible, we're able to flow into the same direction as the heart of God.
그러나 반대로 우리가 악한 영의 다른 영의 이끌림을 받으면
however, if we're led by the evil spirit, the other spirit,
하나님 말씀을 듣는긴 들어도
even though we are listening to the word of God,
우리 마음이 그 마저 다른 방향으로 가도록 이렇게 악한 영을 끌어가요.
But the evil spirit is leading us so that we will go in the opposite direction to the way of God.
참 많은 사람이 성경을 펴서 읽고 있지만
many people have the Bible open, they're reading it.
자기는 하나님 믿는다고 하지만
they say they believe God.
성경에는 하나님 마음을 정확하게 발견하지 못하면
however, if you're unable to discover the precise heart of God through the Bible
자기 어떤 그 길로 가고 있는 거예요.
Then they're walking their own way.
그래서 여러분 거기에서 가장 큰 문제가 뭐냐면
the biggest problem here
내가 죄사함받고 하늘나라 가려면
in order for me to receive forgiveness of sins and go to heaven
우리 인간 관념에다가 사탄은 무슨 생각을 넣었느냐면
inside of man's perception what has Satan put in
내가 착하게 살아야 돼
you have to live a good life
성실해야 돼
you have to be diligent
죄를 짓지 말아야 돼
you have to not commit sin
하나님 기도해야 돼
you have to pray to God
회개해야 돼
you have to repent
그런 생각을 우리 인간 속에 넣었어
these are the thoughts that he puts onto us man
근데 이제 그래서 우리가 하나님이 이야기하는 그 길로 가지 못하도록 만들어.
And he makes us so that we're unable to go to the path that God directs us to.
내가 죄를 지었지만
even though I committed sin.
이렇게 진실하게만 나를 받으실 거야.
Oh, if I'm truthful then God will accept me.
열심히 내 충성하면 도와주실 거야.
If I'm diligently working and devoted God will accept me.
정말 기도를 많이 하면 복을 주실 거야.
If I pray really hard God will accept me and bless me.
그런 생각 속에 빠졌어.
These are the kinds of thoughts people are falling into.
제가 베트남에 갔을 때
I went to Vietnam.
좀 유명한 목사님을 만났어요.
I met a pastor that's very famous.
그분은 복음을 위해서 참 오랫동안 감옥에 있던 사람이었어요.
I heard that he was actually in prison for the gospel for a long time.
베트남에서 정말 이름 있는 분이었어요.
He was a very famous person in Vietnam.
내가 베트남 갔을 때 그분이 나를 만나러 왔어요.
And when I went to Vietnam, he came to meet me.
이야기해요.
And we talked.
그다음 이제 우리가 구원에 대한 이야기를 했어요.
And then we came to the topic of salvation.
제사 안 받고 하늘에 준비가 됐냐고 그랬어요.
I asked him, "Did you receive forgiveness of sins, and are you ready to go to heaven?"
그분은 말하기를.
And what he said.
아, 내가 왜 하늘에 못 가냐고.
He says, "Why can I not go to heaven?"
내가 감옥에서 14년 동안 있습니다.
I was in prison for 14 years.
제가 얘기했습니다.
And this is what I said.
목사님 죄송한데요.
Pastor, I'm sorry.
하늘에는 우리 행위로 가지 않습니다.
But we do not go to heaven due to our works.
그분한테 화를 냈어요.
And then he became very angry at me.
목사님 제가 감옥 살이가 어떤지 아십니까?
Pastor, do you know what prison life is like?
나만 고생한 게 아닙니다.
I'm not the only one who suffered.
내 아이들은 거리에서 과일 껍질 주워 먹고.
My kids, they were on the streets peeling off the peels of the fruits on the streets.
내 아내는 거지 같은 삶을 살았습니다.
And my wife lived like a beggar.
나 고통에 너무 교도소 안에 고통스러웠어.
And it was so painful for me to be inside of prison.
목사님 감옥에 가서 7년 동안 14년 동안 있어 본 적이 있습니까?
Pastor, have you ever been inside of prison for 7 to 14 years?
그 지긋지긋한 일을 지금도 생각 끔찍한데.
Even when I imagine it now, it's so sick and tiring. I don't want to imagine it.
근데 내가 하늘을 못 간단 말입니까?
But you're telling me that I cannot go to heaven?
목사님 하늘은 행위로 가는 게 아닙니다.
Pastor, we do not go to heaven due to our works.
목사님, 예수님 때문에 감옥 가본 적 있습니까?
Pastor, have you ever been to prison for Jesus?
난 예수님 이름으로 감옥 가본 적 없습니다.
No, I've never been to prison for the name of Jesus.
그렇지만,
but
행위로 가는 게 아닙니다.
But we do not go by works.
이야기가 맞지라는 거예요.
And so we could not have a conversation.
그분은 정말 유명한 분이고 믿음의 사람이 하는데.
And so they say that he's very famous. He's actually a man of faith. They say.
하나님에 대해서 정확하게 모르니까.
But because he does not know precisely about God.
내가 이렇게 감옥에서 14년 동안 고생을 했는데.
Even though I suffered like this for 14 years
in prison. 내가 어려운 삶을 살았는데.
I lived a very difficult life.
예수님을 위해 이런데 내가 가나라 못 가요.
But I did these things for Jesus, and you tell me that I cannot go to heaven?
그분은 자기가 주님 앞 충성한 것만 있지.
He only has what he's devoted for Jesus.
하나님의 말씀에 대해 전혀 몰랐어.
He does not know about the word of Jesus.
자 여러분 그분만 그런 게 아닙니다.
Everyone, it's not only for him.
오늘 정말 세계 많은 기독교인들이
today many Christians all across the world
성경 속에 하나님의 사실을 정확하게 알지 모르니까
because they do not know about the exact truth that's inside the Bible.
그러니까 이제 자기 나름대로의 성경을 읽으면서 어떤 길을 만들어 그 길을 가는데. 그 길은 예수님의 길이 아니란 것이.
And so they read the Bible on their own and they make their own way, but that is not the way of Jesus.
여러분 우리는 출애굽기 12장의 유월절에 관한 이야기인데.
Everyone today inside the book of Exodus chapter 12 we talked about the feast of the Passover.
이제 이스라엘 백성들이 430년 동안 이집트에서 종노로 됐습니다.
And the Israelites they were enslaved in Egypt for 430 years.
하나님은 430년이 지나는 날 이스라엘 애굽에서 건져내기로 했습니다.
On the day that 430 days were, 430 years were up, he decided to take them out of Egypt.
그리고 이제 그날 마지막으로 애굽에 재앙을 내리는데.
And so on the last day, he brings down the plague.
그 애굽에 사는 모든 사람 누구든지 간에 장자 제일 맏아들을 한 천사가 죽이는 그 이제 재앙을 내렸어.
And so no matter who it may be, he brought down the plague of killing off the firstborn of every single family.
근데 이제 그날 이스라엘 백성들도 애굽에 살고 있었는데.
And at that time, the Israelites they were also living inside the land of Egypt.
하나님 이스라엘 백성들에게 뭐라고 말했냐면은.
But what God said to the Israelites was.
정월 11일 날 너희가 내 양을 한 마리 준비해라.
It says on the 11th day you shall prepare yourself a lamb. 10th day. On the 10th day of this month it says.
정월 10일 날 양을 한 마리 준비하라.
It says that on the 10th day of this month thou shalt take every man a lamb.
그리고 그 양을 따로 이제 두고
And so you take the lamb separately.
정월 14일 날 저녁에 해질 때 잡아라.
And then on the sunset of the 14th day then you take the lamb.
저월 14일 날 양을 잡아서
And so then on the dawn of on the evening of the 14th day you take the lamb
양을 잡아서 먼저 그 피를 가지고
And then you first take the blood
그 사람이 살고 있는 그 방 그 문에 설주와 임방에 바르었습니다.
And so you take it and then you put it upon the side door post and also the top door post of the door.
이제 설주라는 문이 내가 네모로 돼 있으면은
And so when you talk about this it says four sides of the door
사각형인데 기둥으로 서 있는 이 두 개가 설주고
And so you say the two side posts.
그다음에 밑바닥 위에 있는 그 가로 놓인 그걸 임방이라고 합니다.
And then you say also the upper and the lower door posts.
이야기는 요즘 한국에 전혀 안 쓰는 단어가 돼서.
And so these are words that you don't really use in Korean language now.
설주가 뭔지 아는 사람 거의 없어요.
And so people don't really have an idea of what the side door posts mean.
어떤 설주라 그러니까 뭐 그런 술도 있나 한 사람 있고.
And so someone say that, oh, you know, is there a word like that?
예, 그런데. 설주 그러니까 문 사각으로 돼 있는데 설주와 임방에 발라라.
And so there are the four sides to the door, and so you take it upon the side door post and the upper and lower.
그리고 이제 그 집 안에 들어가라.
And then you go into that house.
그리고 이제 고기를 먹는데.
And then you eat the meat.
허리에 띠를 띠고.
You gird yourself.
발에 신을 신고.
And you put sandals on your feet.
이제 막 출발하 바로 출발할 준비가지고 고기를 먹으라.
And so then, as soon as you're ready, then you get ready to eat the meat.
그리고 이제 하나님 말씀하시기를.
And then according to the word of the Lord.
내가 그 밤에 내 사자를 애굽의 모든 집집마다 들어가서 장자를 다 죽일 거야.
And he said, I will send my angel unto you, and then go into every single household and kill all the firstborn.
근데 이제 들어가 다 죽이는데.
And then I go in and kill them.
그 문에 설주와 임방에 피가 칠해진 그 집은 내가 지나간다, 유월한다. 넘어간다 이런 뜻이죠.
And so then he says that where there is the blood upon the side door post and upper and lower, he says that I will pass over you. That's passing.
예, 여러분 그 영어에서 passover란 말은 많이 쉬운 이야기인데.
And so then the English word passover is very easy to understand.
한국에서 유월 가면 유월인지 칠월인지 그렇게 이해하기 쉬워요.
However, in the Korean word, it's a little difficult to understand whether it's you know.
유월은 넘어간다 이런 뜻인데.
When we say passover, it means to pass, to 예, pass by.
그 넘어간다 그 이제 내가 넘어간다.
And so then he says that I will pass over.
그러니까 이제 하나님이 애굽에 있는 모든 사람에게 맏아들이 죽는 재앙을 내리셨는데.
And so God let down the plague to kill off all the firstborns of the land of Egypt.
하나님은 그들이 얼마나 착했느냐.
How kind were they?
얼마나 진실했느냐.
How truthful were they?
얼마나 열심히 있었느냐.
And how much diligence did they have?
얼마나 정직했느냐.
And how truthful were they?
자 우리가 그냥 생각할 때 하나님 거룩하신 분이니까.
We just think to ourselves, since God, He is a holy one.
착한 사람의 복을 주시고.
God will bless the good.
악한 사람 칼로 찔러 죽이고.
And God will pierce with the sword.
정말 정직한 사람.
And then the ones that are really
성실한,
truthful.
깨끗한 사람은
the clean.
이제 천사가 안 들어가 넘어갈 줄 알았는데.
Thinking that the angel will not go in, but it will pass over them.
이 성경은 그렇게 돼 있지 않아요.
However, this Bible does not say that.
그 사람이 악하고 추하고 더럽고 깨끗 그건 전혀 보질 아니하시고.
Whether they may be evil, filthy, dirty, or good, God does not look at that at all.
그 이제 문 설주와 임방에 피를 칠했느냐 안 칠했느냐 그걸 이제 통해서 하나님은 죽이거나 살리는 일을 결정한다는 겁니다.
And so God is going to decide whether He kills you or save you upon whether you have the blood upon the side door post and the upper door post of that house.
그냥 어떤 사람이든지 문 임방이나 설주에 피가 칠해져 있으면
No matter who it may be, if you have blood upon the side and upper door posts
하나님의 천상 그 집에 왔다 벌써 이 집에 피가 칠했네 저주를 받았구나 건너간다 넘어간다는 거예요
Then the angel of God will come by and says Oh, this house already has the blood upon the door post It already received the curse and it will pass over you
어떤 집에 가보니까 문방에 임방이나 설주에 피가 칠해지지 않았어요
However, it went to some house and the angel of God sees that there is no blood upon the side or upper door post
아, 이 집에는 설주 피가 없네.
Oh, this house doesn't have any sort of blood upon the side or upper door post.
그러면 죽는데.
Then it's gonna die.
근데 적게 칠해서 그런가?
Oh, maybe they didn't have only they only put a little bit.
사사치 살펴보는 거야.
And he starts to look at it very carefully.
사사치 살펴보는데 피가 없어요.
And he starts looking through it carefully, but there is no blood.
그러면 천사 문을 열고 들어 칼로 맏아들을 죽이는 거예요.
Then the angel opened the door, go in, and then take the sword and kill the firstborn.
자, 여러분 이런 이야기는 우리 신앙의 굉장히 깊은 많은 걸 설명해 주고.
Everyone, this story is actually explaining very deep things to our spiritual life.
여러분 대부분의 사람들은 하나님 선하신 분이니까.
For most people, because God is a good God.
내가 정직하고 깨끗하고 그러면. 한 복을 주실 줄 알고.
People just think that if I'm truthful and clean, then God's going to bless me.
악하고 더러면 저주를 받을 줄 그렇게 생각을 해요.
And if I'm evil and dirty, then God will curse me.
여러분 절대로 하나님은 착하고 정직한 사람을 찾아 복을 주는 게 아니에요.
God never looks for people that are good and truthful and blesses them accordingly.
다시 말하면 하나님 앞에 착한 건 뭐냐면은
That in other words, what does it mean to be good in front of God?
남을 도와주는 거나
helping other people
불쌍한 사람들 위해서 일하는 것이나
and helping the people that are needy
그거 아니에요.
That's not what it means.
하나님 볼 때 착한 것은
the good in front of the eyes of God
하나님과 마음을 같이 하는 거예요.
Is uniting your heart with God.
그러니까 다른 건 다 몰라도
and even though you don't know anything else
하나님과 마음이 같은 그 사람을 하나님 받으신다는 거예요.
But whoever has the same heart as God, God accepts him.
그래서 이제 하나님 뭐라고 하냐면은
And then what does God say?
문에 설주와 임방에 피를 칠해라.
It says you shall take the blood and put it upon the side and upper doorposts.
내 그 집에는 넘어가겠다, 유월하겠다. 그래서 유월절인 겁니다.
And then he says that then I will pass over you. That's why we call it Passover.
그러나 아무리 착한 사람이라도
But no matter how good he may be,
임방에 설주에 피가 칠해져 있지 않는 사람은
the person that doesn't have any blood upon the side or upper doorposts.
하나님 문을 천사 문에 장자를 칼로 찔러 죽이겠다.
Then what he will do is he will take the sword and then go and strike the firstborn of that house.
그러니까 여러분 이런 부분이 하나님하고 우리 인간하고 생각이 다른 거예요.
Everyone, in these terms, this is how our thoughts and the heart of God are different.
왜 생각이 다르냐면은요.
The reason why our thoughts are different.
사람들 가운데 자기가 선하다고 생각하는 사람 참 많아요.
Because amongst people, there are many people who think that they're good.
근데 그 선한 것이 자기를 얼마나 선하게 할 수 있느냐?
However, that goodness which they have, how good Can it make them?
왜냐하면 여러분 하나님 볼 때 인간 보는 너무 달라요.
Because the way that God looks at man is very different.
제가 한 번은 대구 파동 있을 때.
One time I was in 대구 파동.
교회에서 제가 말씀을 전하면서.
One time I was preaching the word.
우리가 선한 걸 해서 하늘나라 가지 못한다고 선한 것이 인간에게 하나도 없다고 이야기했어요.
I talked about how through our goodness we're not able to go to heaven. There is no good inside of man.
근데 이제 예배를 마치고 한 부인이 제게 찾아왔어요.
And after the service was over, there was a certain lady who came to me.
그분은 그 파동 좀 약간 가난한 동네인데.
So Padong is actually a very poor area.
뭘 하냐면은 약국을 하고 있어요.
What she used to do was she used to run a pharmacy.
근데 거기는 가난한 사람들이 참 많은데.
But there's a lot of poor people.
약국에 와서 정기적으로 약을 사는 사람들이 있어요.
And so there are some people that are periodically getting the medicine.
예를 들어 이제 폐결핵 같은 경우에
Let's say for example like tuberculosis
약을 먹으면 계속해서 쉬지 않고 먹어야 돼요.
When you take medication you have to take it without ceasing.
만약 약을 먹다가 중단하면
If you let's say take it and then you stop in middle
결핵균이 다 죽지를 않아요.
Then all of the cells of tuberculosis will not die.
근데 결핵균 다 죽지 않는데 이 결핵균은 지금까지 약을 먹었던 균이니까
And so these cells, what they have been doing is taking in all the medication from the tuberculosis medicine.
약을 계속 먹으면 약 결핵균이 죽을 때 전부 죽을 때가 약을 계속 먹어야 하는데.
When you eat the medicine, you're supposed to eat it until all of the cells die off.
결핵균이 약을 먹은 반쯤 죽었는데.
And so when you start taking the medication, half of the tuberculosis cells have died.
약을 중단하면.
But let's say you stop the medication.
결핵균이 다시 살아나요.
Then it brings back the tuberculosis cells back to life.
근데 다시 살아난 이 결핵균은
But then these cells that have revived
약에 대해서 우리 몸에도 한 병이 걸다 나면 면역체계 생겨 병균도 약에 대해서 면역체계가 생겨.
Just as how our body once it gets healed from a certain disease we build immunity to that. That's how these cells are able to also build immunity to the medicine.
근데 그다음에는 그 사람 약을 먹어도 전혀 병이 낫지 않아요.
And so afterwards even though you take that medicine this person will never get healed.
그런 사람들이 참 많아요.
There's a lot of people like that.
근데 결핵은 다 나았다고 할지라도 한 6개월 전 약을 더 먹는 게 원칙이에요.
And so what they usually do is even though you're completely healed, you're supposed to take 6 more months of medication.
근데 결국 약을 먹어 몸에 소화가 잘 안 되는 그런 부작용들이 많이 일어나서.
But there's still a lot of bad side effects because you can't digest well if you take it.
아니 그 어려워 약을 먹는 게 막 어려우니까 다 그만 중단하는데 약을 안 먹으면 안 되니까요.
And so people just say, oh, it's difficult, and then they just stop. And but the thing is, they cannot stop.
이 자매는 그런 걸 너무 잘 알아요.
So this sister knows these things so well.
약사니까.
Because she's a pharmacist.
그래서 어느 누구 누구 집에 결행약 살 시간 되는 뭐 그런 거 다 알잖아요.
So she knows exactly what kind of people are supposed to get there to break the loose's medicine at what day and what time.
그 자매님이 그 약 가지고 이제 그 안 온 사람이 전화해가 좀 약국에 오라 그래요.
So what she does is she calls those people that's supposed to take the medicine and they haven't come and tell them to come.
그 사람 와요.
And then they come.
약 먹을 시간 되면 약 안 사가느냐고.
Oh, it's already due time for you to take the medicine. How come you have not bought it yet?
아, 내가 안다. 그런데 돈이 없어서 약을 사지 못한다.
I know that I'm supposed to take it, but I have no money to buy medicine.
암만 돈이 없지만 약은 먹어야 한다고.
Even though you have no money, but you need to take the medicine.
만약 약을 제때 안 먹으면 나중에 약을 먹으면 당신은 약 있어. 도 죽는다고.
Because if you don't take the medicine at the right time, then later on, even if you do have it, you take it, you will die.
그리고 그 사람 말은 그렇지만 돈이 없는데 어떡하냐고.
That person says, I don't have any money. What do you want me to do?
이분은 자기 약을 줘요.
This person would just give her medicine.
우선 가서 몸이나 살고.
First of all, you need to live.
돈이 되면 가져오라고.
And then later on, when you get the money, just pay me back later.
그렇게 했을 때 이분이 이 부인이 약값을 다 절대 못 받아요.
And so when she does that, she's never able to get all the money back.
내가 손해를 봐가면서 약을 이거 선한 거 아닙니까?
And she says, I receive loss, and I'm doing these things. Aren't these things good?
선한 거죠.
Yes, it's good.
근데 성경은 뭐라고 말하냐면
But what the Bible says
창세기 6장이 이렇게 말해요.
It says in Genesis chapter 6.
여호와께서 사람의 죄악이 세상에 관영한가?
For God saw the wickedness of man was great in the earth.
그 마음의 생각이 모든 계획이 항상 악할 뿐임을 보시고.
And the thoughts of his heart was only evil continuously.
자, 이런 걸 보면 깜짝 놀랍니다.
So the thing is when you see these things it's very shocking.
우리는 생각이 어떤 생각은 악하고 어떤 생각은 선하다고 생각하는
For us, we think certain thoughts are good and certain thoughts are evil.
하나님 생각 우리하고 전혀 다릅니다.
However, the thought of God and our thoughts are totally different.
그 마음의 생각의 모든 계획이 항상 악할 뿐이다.
It says every imagination of his heart was only evil continually.
그 자매님이 목사님 이건 선한 겁니다.
And then the sister said, "But pastor, oh, this is good."
자매님 창세기 6장 봐요.
Sister, look at the words of Genesis chapter 6.
모든 건 항상 악뿐이다 그랬어요.
It says only evil continually.
그게 하나님하고 자매 생각이 다릅니다.
This is the difference between your thought and the thought of God.
그래서 이제 자매 이해가 안 가는 거죠.
And so the sister couldn't understand it.
내가 무슨 이야기를 했냐면
And what I told her was
한 번 미국 시카고에서 제가 집회를 했는데
And so one time I had a conference in Chicago of United States.
그 액세서리 장사하는 그 자매님이 계셨어요.
There was a sister who was running an accessory shop.
그래서 그 액세서리 그 장사하는 자매님 내게 왔다고 저한테 목걸이 금목걸이를 이만큼 뭉쳐 가지고 왔어요.
And so because I came as the guest speaker, she brought this large bundle of all gold necklaces to me.
저는 비행기를 많이 타니까요.
Because I ride the plane often.
어떨 때는 막 공항에 내려 막 빨리 가야 이제 집회 시간 다 할 때가 막 그래요.
Oftentimes I get out of the airplane and then I have to go quickly. I have to run in order for me to be able to get it right time for the conference.
저는 제 가방 안에 공항에 걸릴 거 하나도 안 가져요.
And so inside of my bag, I don't keep anything that with me that will get caught by security.
우리 집 사람은 좀 가져다녀요.
But my wife, she takes a few.
김치도 가져다니고.
She takes kimchi with her.
하여튼 막 그래야지.
And so that's what she does from time to time.
웃지 못할 웃을 일들이 많아.
And so there are a lot of unlaughable things.
그러니까 금목걸이 이 정도 있는 거 이거는 뭐 틀림없이 걸리는 거.
And so this bundle of gold necklaces, this is going to be caught for sure.
제가 가방을 나 그걸 내놨어요.
And so what I did was I took it out of my bag.
그리고 이제 나 이제 비행기 타고 한국에 왔어요.
And then I got on the plane and then I came to Korea.
인천공항에 도착했을 때.
I arrived at the Incheon Airport.
세관은 저한테 뭐 신고할 물건이 있습니까?
The customs agent said, "Oh, is there anything for you to declare?"
없습니다.
Nothing.
실례지만 가방 좀 봐도 되겠습니까?
Would it be okay for me to look at your
보시지요?
bag? Yeah, sure. You can see it.
그분이 금목걸이 만한 덩어리 거죠.
And then this person took out this bundle of gold necklace.
너무 놀래 당황해.
And I was very shocked, actually.
누군가가 아이고 우리 박 목사님이 이걸 이제 버리고 고향 갔구나 해서 내가 어디 간 사이에 그걸 내가 가면 집어넣어 버려.
And so somebody, I don't know who, but then said, "Oh, Pastor Park must have forgotten this." And so while I was gone, they put that back in my bag.
금 목걸이 이 정도 되면 완전 금괴 밀수범입니다.
And so then, if you take this much of gold, then you're going to be caught in for smuggling gold.
박옥수 목사 금괴 밀수자 걸렸다 하고 이제 막 신문에 난리 일이에요.
And this is going to be like the headlines on the newspaper: Pastor Park caught smuggling gold.
내가 이야기를 했습니다.
And so then, this is what I said.
이거 내가 집회를 했는데 그 장사하는 분이 나한테 이렇게 줬는데.
And so I had a seminar, and there was a person who's doing a running a shop selling these things.
이거 순금이 아닙니다.
But this is not pure gold.
순금 같으면 이 많은 비싼 돈을 줄 리가 없습니다.
If it's pure gold, there is no way that they would give me large amounts like this.
그랬더니 세관을 한 말이 우리는 맥기양을 순간 그 구분 못합니다.
And then the people at customs they say we have no way to distinguish whether it's real or fake.
아, 빨리 나가야 한다. 난리가 났어.
And I have to get out, but there was a big problem.
아, 이건 누가 가방에 넣었어?
I thought who put this in my bag?
그래서 이제 제가 뭐 실례지만 칼 하나 구할 수 있습니까?
And then I said, oh, excuse me, but can I borrow a knife?
아, 칼이야 구할 수 있죠.
Yeah, sure, we can give a knife to you.
하나 구해다 주세요.
And so then, please give me one.
가져왔어요.
And so they brought one.
한번 긁어보라 했어요.
I said, you can try carving it.
이거 긁어도 괜찮습니까?
Oh, is it okay for us to carve it?
나 책임 안 집니다.
Oh, I'm not going to take responsibility.
내가 긁어라 그러잖아,
긁어. But I'm telling you, do it.
막 긁었어요.
So they started carving.
여러분, 금목걸이는
Everyone, gold necklaces
긁어도 긁어도 금이 나와요. 금목걸이에요.
It has to be gold, even though you carve it.
급질만 약간 다 긁으니까 딴새가 나오니까.
And so then, just the coating is gold. So then you carve it, and then immediately another type of metal came out.
세관은 아이고 웃으면서 가져가러 가더라고.
And immediately they just laughed and said, "Oh, you can just take all of it."
그제 막 진짜 비행기 탈 때, 그 저는 막 차례 막 걸리니까 안 가지다.
And so for me, really, when I ride the plane, I don't take anything that will stop me.
누가 목사님 그래 이제 교회 갔다 나왔더니 막 형제하면서 막 좋다면 다 하나씩 갖다가.
And so then I took it to our church, and all the brothers and sisters were happy. They all took one.
그러니까 이제 그거는 표면적인 면에 볼 때 금 같지만은.
And so on the surface, it looks like gold necklace.
속에 파보면 금이 아니고 딴새예요.
But then when you actually carve it through, you see that it's not gold, but it's a different type of metal.
무슨 이야기냐면은.
What does this mean?
자매님이 선한 것은
Sister, your goodness
자매님 마음속 깊은 데서 선한 것만 계속 나와야 선한 거지.
There has to be constant good that comes out from the deepest part of your hearts for it to be good.
어떤 사람 뭐라 그런지 알아요?
You know what some people say?
예, 참다 참다 못 참겠다 화내잖아. 그죠?
They say that I try to hold it in and hold it in I can't hold it anymore.
그 화를 낸 거예요.
And eventually they get mad.
근데 화가 나는데 참은 거지.
And so they were angry but they just held it in.
그냥 하나님 볼 때 선한 게 아니라는 거예요.
But doesn't mean that it's good in the eyes of God.
여러분은 금목걸이 깎아도 깎아도 금반지 깎아도 금이 나와요, 금이.
Everyone it has to be gold for pure gold for it to be gold even though you carve it and carve it and carve it.
선한 사람은 깎아도 깎아도 선만 나와야 하는데.
For a person who's good, even though you carve them out, there has to be good.
찾다가 찾다가 화가 팍 나면.
And so you hold it, hold it, and eventually there's anger.
맥기한 선을 맥기한 사람이에요.
And that is the fake good. That is a fake person.
하나님 볼 때 선한 것이 아니에요.
That is not goodness in the eyes of God.
그렇기 때문에 여러분들 선하고 여러분 뭐 믿음 있고 여러분 십일조 했고 여러분 충성했고 여러분 기도 많이 했고 그거 다. 하나님 인정 안 한다는 거.
And that's why whether you were good or whether you gave tithe, whether you were devoted, whether you did all these things, God does not acknowledge any of it.
오늘 많은 종교적인 개념을 가지고 어떤 마음을 가지고 있냐면
Many people have a religious perception of what they think.
내가 좀 잘못한 게 있지만은
Even though there are some things which I did wrong.
착하게 살고 충성하고
well,
기도하고 하면
If I'm devoted and if I pray.
죄가 씻어질 걸로 생각.
Then they think that their sins will be washed.
절대 그렇지 않아.
That will never happen.
그래서 여러분 그 믿음의 세계 속에 들어갈 때
Therefore when you enter into that life of faith
인간 생각과 하나님 생각이 근본적으로 다르기 때문에
Naturally the thought of man and the thought of God are different.
여러분의 생각이 손끝만큼 들어가기 시작하면
That's why even if there's a speck of your works that start going into this
하나님 말씀 삐뚤 조속하기 때문에 저주와 멸망을 받아야 돼.
Then it will set the word of God off course and eventually you have to be destroyed and being cursed.
그러니까 이제 우리가 출애굽기에 유월절에 관한 이야기를 읽어보면,
when we read through the book of Exodus about the word of the Passover,
그 동네 선하기로 이름 난 사람들,
the people that were famous to be good in that town,
진지하게 정말 선하게 산 사람들,
the people that lived a very truthful and also sincere life,
뭐네 피바는 게 뭐가 중요해? 내가 선은 행하면 됐지.
They think, what's the use of having put blood on the doorpost? I can just live a good life.
문털주에 바르던 뭐 뭐야 그 임방에 바르든 피 안 발라도 난 선하니까 괜찮아.
Oh, whether I put it upon the side doorpost, upper doorpost, it doesn't matter. Why? Because I'm good.
저 사람들 죄를 많이 지었으니까 저 뭐야 피를 발라야 하는지 모르지만.
Oh, maybe those people because they committed a lot of sin, they need to put the blood on the doorpost.
난 선하기 때문에 그러지 않아도 돼.
Well, I'm good, so I don't need to do that.
그러니까 이제 그런 마음을 가진 사람이 많은 거예요.
So that's why there are many people who have those hearts.
근데 이제 하나님은 뭐라고 말하냐면,
however, what does God say?
천사가 선한 것이나 악한 걸 본다고 안 했어요.
God says he does not look at whether it's good or evil.
하나님은 충실했거나 안 충실 그것도 보지 않는다 그랬어요.
He also says he's not going to look at whether you were devoted or not.
정직하거나 정직하지 않거나 그것도 보지 않는다 그랬어요.
He says he's not going to look at whether you were sincere or not.
하나님은 유일하게 보는 것 그것은 문설주와 임방에 피가 칠했느냐 안에 그걸 봐.
The only thing that he's going to look at is whether you have blood upon the side and upper doorposts or not.
자, 우리가 성경을 읽으면 이런 분들 굉장히 많습니다.
Everyone, as we read through the Bible, there are many aspects like this.
근데 여러분, 우리는 하나님 말씀 들으면 그래도 막연하게 내 생각에 따라간다는 거예요.
And even though the word of God is there, we still vaguely follow our thoughts.
우리 자주 제가 성경 이야기하다 가늠한 여자 이야기를 하는데,
oftentimes I talk about the woman caught in the act of adultery.
오늘 그 이야기를 했습니다만,
this time around I talked about this.
가늠한 여자 왜 가늠을 했습니까?
Why did the woman caught in the act of adultery commit adultery?
음란한 마음 일어나서요?
Because she had a lustful heart?
아닙니다.
No way.
음란한 마음이라 다 가늠하는 거 아니에요.
Just because you have a lustful heart doesn't mean you commit adultery.
왜냐면 음란한 마음이 가늠을 하고 싶은 마음이 일어나도,
because even though you have the lustful heart, you want to commit adultery.
그 당시에 가늠하다 잡힌 돌에 맞아 죽기 때문에.
But during that time, if you're caught committing adultery, you'll be stoned to death.
내가 가늠하다가 안 들킬 수도 있겠지만,
and they think that even though they may not be caught committing adultery,
만약 가늠하다 들키면 돌에 맞아 죽어.
But if I'm caught committing adultery, then I'll be stoned to death.
그러면 가늠하고 싶은 생각 다 도망가 버리는 거예요.
Then all those thoughts of wanting to commit adultery will go away.
근데 가늠한 사람은 누가 가늠을 하냐면,
but the people that commit adultery, who are they?
내가 이렇게 가늠하면 안 잡힐 거야.
Even though I commit adultery like this, I will not be caught.
그렇게 생각을 가늠을 하는 거예요.
If you think that way, then you commit adultery.
그러니까 제가 교도소에 참 오랫동안 재소자 교육을 했는데,
and so I educated many of the inmates that were inside of prison for a long time.
교도소에 온 사람들 무슨 생각하지 알아요?
Do you know what the people that are inside of prison think?
이번에 어찌다 잡혔지?
How did I get caught this time?
아, 그 남편 퇴근할 그 시간에 내가 도둑질하러 들어갔어.
Oh, I went and stole right at the time when the husband came back from work.
아, 다음에는 그때 안 들어가면 안 잡힐 것 같은 마음이 들어요.
They think inside their hearts, if they miss that time, then they will not be caught.
아, 내가 이번에는 지문을 남겨 잡혔어.
This time I left my fingerprints. That's why I was caught.
다음에 내가 지문 안 나 안 잡힐 것 같은 그런 생각이 들어요.
They think in their hearts, if I don't leave my fingerprints this time, I will not be caught.
그런 사람 누구냐면은,
who are these people?
한 평생 교도소 안에 사는 사람들.
These are the people that live in prison for life.
그 교도소에 들어와 내가 이번에 왜 잡혔지?
So they come into prison. They think, why did I get caught?
지문 남겨 잡혔구나.
Oh, I left my fingerprints.
공장과 기어서 지문 안 잡힐 것 같으면 다음에 또 그래 하고 싶은 거예요.
If I wear rubber gloves this time, I will not be caught. They want to do it again next time.
또 잡혀요.
You're going to get caught again.
그러니까 이제 자기 생각을 믿는 거예요.
So that means that they trust their own thoughts.
자, 이제 도박을 하면 왜 도박을 해요?
The people that gamble, why do they gamble?
자기 생각을 믿어요.
It's because they trust their thoughts.
자, 이제 머신을 당겼을 때에,
and so when you pull on the slot machine,
돈이 나왔다고 생각해봐요.
Let's say that you have money that comes out.
좋겠지요.
It will be good, right?
다 좋아해요.
Yeah, that'd be good for everybody.
돈 싫어하는 사람이 없으니까.
Nobody dislikes money.
근데 그 도박을 하는 사람 가운데서,
but among the gamblers,
돈을 원하는 사람 가운데 그냥 원하는 사람이 아니고,
it's not the people that just want the money.
내가 돈을 잃어가지고 내가 자살할 장대가 된다든지 우리 집이 망한다든지 큰 문제가 일어날 때는,
let's say at a point where because they lost the money that they want to commit suicide or there's a problem inside their family, they will break apart.
이제 그 돈을 다시 그 복구하고 싶은 다시 찾고자 하는 그 마음이 막 불타기 시작해.
Then it starts to burn inside of them, the heart and the desire of wanting to recover that money.
자, 여러분 사람들 정상적인 사람들은 길 갈 때 아무 냄새가 안 나지만은
Normal people as they're walking the street they don't smell anything but
우리가 배고픈 멀리 음식 생각이 냄새가 나지요.
However if we're hungry then we're able to smell the food that's from far away, right?
그래요. 배고픈 막 멀리 냄새도 나는 거예요.
That's right. If we're hungry then we're able to smell food from far
그렇죠?
away.
내가 돈이 필요하다는 게 크면 클수록
Likewise, the stronger the desire for the need of money,
내가 도박에 돈을 따고 싶은 마음이 큰 거예요.
The heart of me wanting to make money out of gambling is greater.
그 돈을 따고 싶은 마음이 크면 클수록 이번엔 하면 돈이 나 딸 것 같은 마음이 들어요.
And the greater desire of wanting to make that money, then you start to think that you can make money out of it.
그래서 이제 다시 도박을 해요.
That's how they gamble again.
돈을 잃어요.
And they lose it.
근데 이번엔 꼭 딸 것 같은 마음이 들어요.
But they think inside their hearts that they're gonna win this time.
그 도박하는 사람들 그는 곧 자기 뭐 아내 수술비까지 갖다 그 도박하잖아요.
And these people, they even take the money that's for their wife's surgery and they will just put it into that gambling.
왜 그 사람 돈을 딸 것 같으니까.
Why? Because he thinks that he's gonna win.
딴다면 무슨 돈을 가도 문제가 안 되죠.
If he's gonna win, then it's not a problem what money he takes.
근데 정상적인 사람은
However, normal people
따고 딸 것 같은 마음이 들어요.
They think that they're gonna win.
근데 가서 도박을 했는데,
but then I went and gambled.
잃었어요.
And I lost.
그 다음에 딸 같은 마음이 일어날 때,
and then the next time around when I think that I'm gonna win again.
지난번에 딸 같은 마음이 왔는데 내가 잃었네.
Oh, last time I thought that I was gonna win, but I lost.
그럼 지금 딸 같은 마음이 와도 이번 이걸 잃을 수 있겠네.
And this time around I think that I'm gonna win, but I might lose again.
이제 그렇게 생각이 들면은,
if you can think like this,
도박을 끊을 수 있어요.
That's how you can quit gambling.
근데 도박을 계속 하는 이야기는,
but the reason why you keep gambling,
이번엔 꼭 딸 것 같은 거예요.
He thinks that he's going to win this time.
지난번에 딸 것 같은데 잃었는데.
Last time he thought he was going to win and he lost.
그 생각이 안 나요.
He doesn't think that way.
이번엔 분명히 딸 것 같은 거.
I'm going to win for sure this time.
그래서 도박을 해요.
That's why he gambles.
잃어요.
And he loses.
이번엔 또 딸 것 같아요.
I think I'm going to win again.
그래서 이제 집을 다 망치고 막 재산이 날라 그렇게 되는 거예요.
This is how he ruins his house and then just sells off his whole house, everything.
그 사람들이 선한 것을 필요로 할 때
when people are in need of something
내가 선의 하나를 안다고 생각하면은
when they think that I want to become good
선을 하고 싶은 마음도 일어나고
then they have the desire of wanting to be good
내가 선을 했다는 그런 생각도 일어나는
they
거예요.
They also have thoughts that they've committed good.
그 자기는 선함 이만하면 하나를 갈 만하다고 준비 생각하는 사람이 많아요.
There are many people who think that they are good enough and they're well prepared to go to heaven.
근데 여러분 하나님은 우리 하나님은 선한 사람을 뽑는 게 아니고
However, God does not choose the good to go to heaven.
정직한 사람을 뽑는 것도 아니고
He does not choose the truthful.
누굴 뽑느냐 하면은
Who does he choose?
문에 피를 칠한 사람만 하나님이 찾는 거예요.
God only looks for the people that have the blood upon the doorpost.
그가 누구든지 간에
No matter who he may be.
얼마나 잘났든 못났든지 간에.
No matter how great, no matter how bad he may be.
근데 하나님, 네가 진짜 내 말을 순종하려면.
If you truly want to obey my word.
다른 선하지 말고.
Don't do any other good.
문설주 임마 피를 발라라.
Then take the blood and put it upon the side and upper doorpost.
나는 피를 보고 볼 때만 넘어간다.
He says, when I see the blood, I will pass over.
네가 아무리 선할지라도.
No matter how good you may be.
문설주 임마 피가 없으면. 넌 죽는다.
If you do not have any blood upon the side and upper doorpost, you will die.
하나님 그렇게 말씀.
That's what God said.
근데 오늘날 많은 사람들.
However, many people today.
교회 다니면서.
Even though they go to church.
내가 충성하려고 애쓰고.
They are devoted to try to do well.
선하려고 애쓰고.
They try hard to be good.
기도하고.
They pray.
봉사 잘하면 자기가 평가하는 좋은 점수 딱 내면.
And then when they volunteer and they do all these things and they grade themselves a good score.
하나님을 좋은 점수를 줄 줄 알고 쏟고 있는 거야.
Then they're deceived, thinking that God will also score them high.
그러니까 출애굽기 12장 13절에 뭐라고 되냐면은.
And that's why inside the words of Exodus chapter 12 verse 13 says.
아까 제가 이걸 그 빼먹었다 다시 이야기했지 그죠?
So this was the last verse that I forgot, right?
내가 애굽 땅을 칠 때 그 피가 너희 거하는 집에 있어서 너희를 위하여 표징이 될지라.
And it says, and the blood shall be for you token upon the houses where you are, and when I see the blood, I will pass over you.
내가 피를 볼 때에 너희를 넘어가리니 재앙이 너희께 내리 멸하지 아니하리라.
And when I see the blood, I shall pass over you, and the plague shall not be upon you, destroy when I smite the land of Egypt.
하나님은 우리를 저주받고 멸망만 구원하시기 위해서
And so for us to be not for us to be destroyed and also to receive destruction
선한 사람을 살려준다 이 얘기가 아닙니다.
God is not saying that he is going to save the good.
다 죽이는데.
He says that he will kill everyone.
누구를 살리느냐?
But who does he save?
착한 사람이냐?
The good.
얼굴이 예쁜 사람이냐?
The pretty.
정직한 사람이냐?
The truthful.
율법을 잘 지키는 사람이냐?
The people who keep the law.
기도 많이 하는 사람이냐?
The people who pray.
그거 전혀 보지 않는 날.
The people that offer, he doesn't look at any of that.
하나님은 피가 문설주와 임방에 치는 아니야. 그걸 본다.
All he looks at is whether you have the blood upon the side and upper doorpost or not.
자, 여러분, 우리는 오늘 저기 성경 일감 이야기했지, 그죠?
Everyone, we read through the Bible as we spoke, right?
맞습니까?
Is that right, everyone?
지금 내가 성경대로 이야기를 하고 있습니까?
Everyone, am I speaking according to the words of the Bible?
성경 그렇게 말하죠.
That's what the Bible says, right?
자, 여러분 속에 착한 사람도 있고 또 덜 착한 사람도 있고.
And so among you there are the good and there are people that are less good.
아주 악한 사람도 있고 좀 덜 악한 사람도.
There are people that are extremely evil and then there are people that are less evil.
자, 이야기를 합시다.
Let me say.
사람은 자기가 볼 때 기준 볼 때 그런데.
And so according to people's standards that's how it seems.
하나님 볼 때는
But in the eyes of God
똑같아요.
Everybody's the same.
여러분 개미 보면 큰 거 없고 똑같지요.
Everyone, when you look at ants, there's no bigger one, smaller. They all look the same, right?
예, 똑같아요.
Yes, they all look the same.
여러분 때 선하고 덜 선하고, 여러분 나 인간 세계에는 그게 있는데.
And so among the world of man, there is people that are good, and then there are people that are less good.
세상에는 그런 층을 짓는 방법 여러 가지가 있어요.
And so inside the world, there are many different ways to be able to decide that level.
여러분 그 전문가 축구 잘하면 어떻게 정합니까? 공을 잘 차는 그런 사람이 인정을 받아요.
And so then, how are you able to distinguish the really good soccer players, the people that can play soccer well? That's how you distinguish them.
어떤 사람은 머리 좋은 사람 공무원 시험 칠 때 시험 쳐가지고 성적 좋은 사람 뽑는 거예요.
And then the people that are really smart, how do you distinguish them? People that have a good exam score, and then they're able to be passed.
근데 하나님은 우리가 선할지라도,
however, whether we may be good,
근본 악하기 때문에,
but we are naturally evil.
그 선가에 안 된다는 거예요.
He's saying with that good, we cannot do it.
정직하지를 정직하지가 안 되고,
and even with our truthfulness, it cannot be done.
십계명 많이 지켜도 그거에 안 되고,
even if you keep the Ten Commandments, it cannot be done.
기도 많이 해도 그거 안 되고,
even if you pray hard, it cannot be
왜?
done. Why?
우리는 남보다 선해서 선하다고 보는데.
Because we are better than others, and we think that we are good.
다 악하다.
But God says it is all evil.
그래서 여러분 우리 인간은 선한 게 아니고.
And therefore, our goodness is not good.
매끼한 선을 가지고 다니는 사람이에요.
We are people that carry around the fake good.
맞습니까?
Is that right, everyone?
예.
Yes.
더러운 예를 들어 말하면 금목걸이.
Let's say, for example, the gold necklace. 그
표면적인 건데 금목걸이처럼 보입니다.
On the surface, it looks like it's gold necklace.
그러나 칼로 끌고 봤을 때,
but then when you take a knife and you start scraping it,
표면만 금이지 금물을 먹인 거지.
On the surface, it's only coated with gold.
그 안에 들어가면 노시 나오거나 다른 구리가 나오고 쇠가 나온다.
When you look inside of it, you have copper or you have other types of metal.
금목걸이가 아닙니다.
It's not gold necklace.
진짜 금목걸이는
and so whether if it's true gold,
마르고 딸토록 금이 나와요 금목걸이가.
You have to scrape and scrape and scrape all the way down. It still has to be gold.
Amen.
Amen.
근데 우리 여러분 인간 가운데는
but everyone amongst us men,
정말 순금 목걸이처럼
like the pure gold necklace.
끌고도 끌고도 까도 세월이 흘러도 금만 나오듯이
just as how even though you scrape and scrape and you scrape away and time passes and still there's gold.
암만 끌고 나가도 선만 나온 사람은 한 명도 없어요.
There is not a single person where even if you continue to scrape away, there will be always good.
그래서 하나님 우리의 선한 기준 가지고 하는 기준 잡으면 다 하나님한테 악밖에 안 되는 거예요.
And therefore, if we take our own standard of good and we compare it to the standard of God, it is not good. It's only evil.
그래서 하나님은 뭘로 선을 잡느냐면
therefore, how does God decide is good?
너희가 선하면은
if you are good,
내 말을 들어라.
Then listen to my word.
문설주님만 피를 발라라.
Put the blood upon the side and upper doorpost.
내가 그걸 선으로 여겨 주겠다.
I will consider that as good.
그러니까 이제 막 죄 많은 사람, 아이고 난 분명히 죽을 것 같아. 피 칠한다고 살겠나? 아이고 죄가 많은데.
And so people that have committed the sin, they think inside their hearts, oh, I've committed so much sin. Oh, even though I put the blood upon the doorpost, will I be able to live?
그렇게 생각을 해요.
That's what they think.
그러나 그건 잘못된 생각이에요.
But that's a wrongful thought.
나는 피를 볼 때 건너간다면 건너가는 거야.
If God says that when he sees the blood he will pass over you, that means he will pass over you.
그러면 피가 뭔데 피를 바르면 안 죽여.
So what is the blood that you put the blood there on and then you will not die?
왜 단놈 다 죽으면 피를 문에 바르면 안 죽이는 거야?
Why does it that when you put the blood on there then everybody else will die but I won't die?
간단합니다.
Very simple.
아주 간단 대답은.
Very simple answer.
그 어린 양은 예수님을 가리킵니다.
That young lamb represents Jesus.
예수님이 하나님의 어린 양이라고 합니다.
Jesus is the young lamb of God.
그래서 하나님은 어린 양이기 때문에
Because he is the young lamb of God.
어린 양은 우리 죄를 위하여 십자에 못 박혀 죽으시러 오셨어요.
The young lamb came to be able to die on the cross for our sins.
그 십자가에 못 박혀 피를 흘리고 죽었을 때
Therefore the moment that he shed his blood and died upon the cross.
어떤 일이 난지 아십니까?
Do you know what kind of things took place?
우리 죄값이 그걸 끝나는 걸로 하나님은 정했다.
God decided that all of the wages of our sin were put to an end.
하나님은 그걸 법으로 정했어요.
That's how God decided as the law.
그래서 우리는 우리 그 문에 설주와 임방에 피가 발리운 것처럼
Just as how there was the blood that's put upon the side and also upper doorposts.
우리 마음에는 내가 선한 건 정직한 건 11절에 기도한 거 뭐 그 다 그거 안 되고
For me, I think of me for all the good, the truthfulness, all the offering and all the goods which I did and that's not going to work.
죄를 지었기 때문에
But because I committed sin.
우리 죄를 대신 십자에 못 박기 위한 예수 그리스도의 피.
And only by the blood of Jesus Christ.
예수 그리스도의 그 피를 볼 때 우리 넘어간다.
And so he says, when I see the blood of Jesus Christ, then I will pass over you.
그래서 우리 마음에 내 선한 것도 버려야 하고.
So we have to throw away all of our goodness in our hearts.
율법적인 것도 버려야 하고.
We have to throw away all the law keeping in our hearts.
내가 뭐 다른 거 다 필요 없고.
We don't need anything else inside of our heart.
하나님의 아들 예수 그리스도가 내 죄를 십자에 못 박혀 죽었으니까.
Only because the Son of God, Jesus Christ, died on the cross for my sins.
예수 십자에 못 박혀 죽은 내 모든 죄가 사해졌으니까.
And because by His blood, all my sins were washed.
나를 이 피를 보고 나를 받으시오.
God will accept me looking at this blood.
여러분 그 이런 이야기 성경에. 많이 있는데.
And so there are many stories like this inside the Bible.
창세기 40장에 보면
If you look at Genesis chapter 40,
요셉이 애굽에 팔려가 술 마던 가는 떡 굽는 가는 장에 꿈을 해석하는 얘기다.
There's a story about how Joseph he was sold as a slave into the land of Egypt and eventually he's able to interpret the dream of the chief baker and the chief butler.
예, 떡 굽는 가는 장은 꿈을 꾸었고 술 마던 가는 꿈을 꿨는데.
So the chief butler and the chief baker they both dreamt the dream.
술 마던 관장은 꿈에 보니까 자기의 포도나무가 있었어요.
And so then inside of the dream of the chief butler there was a vine before him.
가지 셋이 있고
three branches.
싹이나 꽃이 피고 포도 송이가 열매 맺어 익었어요.
It said it budded and then it shot forth grapes and then it began to ripe.
그래서 이 술 마던 관장 그 포도즙을 따가서 즙을 짜서 그 포도즙을 가지고 왕에게 갖다 드렸다.
And so what the chief butler did was he squeezed the juice from the grapes and then took it upon the cup and gave it to the king.
요셉이 그걸 해석을 하는데.
So Joseph he interpreted this dream.
기가 막힌 해석.
And he gives a remarkable interpretation.
세 가지는 사흘이다.
And he said the three branches represent 3 days.
사흘 뒤에
After 3 days
왕이 당신을 그 전직을 복직시킨다.
Then the king he will restore your position.
그래 감옥에 나간다는 이야기죠.
That means he will come out of prison.
술 마던 관장 너무 너무 좋았어.
And then the chief butler he was very happy.
또 꿈는 거 아니지? 아 나도 그런 비슷한 꿈 꿨는데.
And the chief baker said, Oh, I had a similar dream too.
나도 꿈에 보니까 내 머리에 흰떡 세 강주리가 있는데.
When I saw my dream, I had 3 white baskets of bread on my head.
제일 위 강주리에 각종 구운 식물이 있는데.
And then on the top basket there were all manner of baked goods.
공중의 새들이 그것을 먹더라.
And then the birds came and ate of it.
그래 요셉 꿈을 해석한데
And then Joseph interpreted the dream.
새 광주는 3일이다.
The 3 baskets represent 3 days.
3일 후에 바로 당신의 목을 매단다.
3 days later, Pharaoh he will hang you upon a tree.
그리고 이제 그 새들이 당신의 고기를 뜯어먹게 된다.
And then the birds will come and eat off of your flesh.
그래 제가 이제 봤어요.
And so I took a look at it.
왜 술 마던 관 떡 굽는 거지 꿈이 그래.
Why was the dream of the chief butler and the chief
baker like
that? 난
요셉의 말을 듣고 해석은 알았는데.
And so then I understood the interpretation, but
왜 술 마던 관장은 사는 어떻게 해서 사는 거고 떡 굽는 관장은 죽는 건가?
How was it possible that the chief baker butler lived and the chief baker died?
우리가 성찬식 할 때 떡과 포도주를 가지고 성찬식하죠.
So when we do the Holy Communion, we take the bread and the cup, and that's how we do the Holy Communion.
내 몸을 위해서 지켜준 예수님의 몸을 가리키는 거고.
The bread represents the body of Christ that was struck for me.
이제 포도주는 나를 위해 흘린 예수의 피를 의미하는.
And the wine and the cup represents the blood of Jesus that was shed for me.
그러니까 이제 성경에 유월절 어린 양의 피나 성찬식 때 피는 그 피는 우리의 죄를 대신해 주신 예수님의 피를 가리켜 말하는.
Therefore, the blood that we represent in the Holy Communion or the Passover, it's talking about the blood of Jesus Christ that was shed for all of our sins.
나는 죄를 많이 지었지만,
even though I committed many sins.
자 이제 이 포도주를 들고 나가는 거죠.
And when I take this wine before me.
자 왕이여 이거 보십시오. 난 죄를 지었지만.
Oh, King, please take a look at it. Even though I committed a lot of sins.
여기 포도주는 내 죄의 벌을 다 받은 예수님의 피입니다.
But this wine is the blood of Jesus who washed away all of my sins.
그 나를 보지 마시고.
So please do not look at me.
내 죄를 대신 벌받은 예수님의 피를 보십시오. 그리고 나를 받으시옵소서.
But look at this blood of Jesus who's been shed for me, and then please accept me.
하나님 그걸 이야기합니다.
That's what God is referring to.
그래 술 마던 가는 장은 구원을 받았어요.
Therefore, the chief baker, a butler, was able to be saved.
그 뜨꾸는 가는 장은 멸망을 당한 겁니다.
But the chief butler received destruction.
왜 멸망을 당했습니까?
Why was he destroyed?
흰떡 세 광주니 그리스도 예수 우리 몸 지킨 몸을 가져가면 되는데.
Because the white baskets of bread, the three of them, they represent the body of Jesus. You can just take
that. 그 뭐가 부족해서.
But because he lacks some thereof.
그거야 안 돼. 그에 뭐 또 각종 구운 식물을 갖다 올려놔.
That's why on top of that he put other big goods on top.
야 우리를 우리가 천국 가는 것은
Everyone, for us to go to heaven,
우리 선으로 가는 게 아닙니다.
We don't go through our goodness.
순서로 가는 것도 아니고
We don't go through our devotion.
기도로 가는 것도 아니고
We don't go through our prayers.
열심으로 가는 게 아닙니다.
We don't go through our diligence.
우리는 죄를 지었기 때문에
Because we committed sin.
그 죄를 해결해야 하는데
We have to get the sin resolved.
우리 죄를 해결한 예수의 피밖에 없는 것입니다.
The only way for our sins to get resolved is the blood of Jesus.
그래서 예수의 피는 우리를 천국에 부족하면 완벽한
And that's why the blood of Jesus is perfect to send us into heaven.
창세기 40장에 술 맡은 가는 꿈이나
Whether it may be the dream of the chief baker, a butler, in the words of Genesis chapter 40.
출애굽기 12장 유월절의 어린 양의 피나 똑같은 의미입니다.
Or whether it may be the blood of the young lamb on the Passover in Genesis chapter
12. 자 하나님 여기 보세요.
God, look here.
이 포도주가 있지 않습니까?
The wine is here.
이 포도주는 우리를 흘린 예수의 피를 가리키는 말입니다.
This wine represents the blood of Jesus that was shed for me.
내가 죄를 지었습니다.
Yes, I committed sin.
그런데 내 죄를 대 예수님 피를 흘리고 죽었습니다.
But Jesus, He shed His blood on the cross for me and saved me from my sins.
예, 내 죄를 피를 흘리고 죽었어. 내 죄값이 끝난 것입니다.
If He shed His blood and saved me from my sins, then all of my wages of my sin is done.
그럼 우리가 뭐만 의지합니까?
What do we only rely upon?
예수의 피만 힘입어 할라.
We are strengthened only by the blood of Jesus, and we go to heaven.
교회 성도들이 그럽니다.
Many people that go to church say this.
찬송, 그 피로 속죄함 얻었네. 찬송.
And so they sing the hymn, saying that I'm redeemed by the blood of the Lamb.
노래 부르고 기도합시다.
So then they sing, and then they say, "Let's pray."
오 주여 이 죄인을 용서해 주옵소서.
Oh Lord, please forgive this sinner.
앞뒤가 안 맞죠.
It doesn't make sense. Front and back.
그 피로 속죄 안 받았다고.
He just said he was redeemed by the blood of the Lamb.
그다음 또 죄를 용서해 달라고.
And then now he's saying, "Forgive me of my sins."
하나님 헷갈리게 하잖아요.
You're confusing God.
말도 안 되는 겁니다.
Doesn't make any sense.
왜요?
Why?
정확하게 믿음을 갖지 못.
Because they were not able to have precise faith.
예수님의 피는 이론이 아니고.
Everyone, the blood of Jesus is not theory.
십자가에 못 박혀 죽으실 때.
But when he was crucified upon the cross.
흘린 그 피는.
That blood which he shed.
우리를 모든 죄에서 깨끗게 했습니다.
Cleansed us of all of our sins.
그래서 여러분 구약 출애굽기에서 그 피를 문설주와 임방에 바르는 것은
That's why when you take the blood thereof in the words of Exodus and put it up on the side and upper doorposts
내가 죽어야 대신에 이미 양이 대신 죽었어
Even though I should have died but the lamb died in my place
이제 이미 사망이 지나갔어
That means that death has already passed this home
천사 그냥 지나가
Angel just passes by
유월해 그 유월절인 겁니다
Pass over us. That's what it means. Passover.
그렇기 때문에 여러분 우리가 구원받는 것은
Therefore, for us to be saved, everyone.
내 행위는 절대 되지 않기 때문에.
It is never done by my works.
예수님 십자가에 못 박혀 죽으실 때.
Therefore, when Jesus was crucified upon the cross.
피를 흘리셨을 때.
When he shed his blood.
그때 이미 예수님은 우리의 죄 값을 모두 받은 것입니다.
That day Jesus already received all the punishment of our sins.
우리가 하늘나라 갈 때 피를 힘입어 나가는.
And so when we go into heaven, we are strengthened by the blood.
제사장이 지성소에 들어갈 때에
When the high priest goes into the most holy place,
피를 힘입어 들어가는.
It says he is strengthened by the blood.
제사장이 잘못하면 저주를 받을 수밖에 없고 제사장이 지성소에 죽을 수 있는데
When the high priest does something out of wrong and then when he goes into the most holy place, he may die.
피 없이는 안 들어가는 겁니다.
But without the blood, he cannot go in.
그 어린 양의 피를 가지고
When you take the blood of the young lamb,
난 부족합니다. I'm lacking. 실수도 있고 죄가 있습니다.
Yes, I made mistakes. I did wrong. I had done wrong.
어린 양의 피는
But the blood of the young lamb
내 죄를 위해 죽으신 예수님을 가리킵니다.
It represents the Jesus Christ who died for me on the cross.
예수님 십자가에 걸린 그 피는
That blood of Jesus Christ
오늘 우리 모두의 죄를 사했기 때문에
Because it washed away all of our sins today.
우리가 구원을 얻는 것은
So for us to be saved
그 피밖에 없습니다.
Is only by that blood.
찬송이 많은 이런 찬송이 있어요.
And so then there's a hymn like that.
나의 죄를 씻기는 예수의 피밖에 없네.
What can wash away my sins? Nothing but the blood of Jesus.
예수의 피밖에 없어.
Only nothing but the blood of Jesus.
이스라엘 백성 이제 430년도 애굽의 종노로 살아가.
And so as the Israelites, they were enslaved inside the land of Egypt for 430 years.
마지막에 가나안으로 가는데.
And the last day when they land out and they went to the land of Canaan.
가나안으로 갈 수 있는 사람은.
The people that are able to go into the land of Canaan.
문설주와 임방의 피를 바른 사람.
They are the people that have the blood upon the side and upper doorposts.
하나님 어린 양 된 예수님이 우리 위해 피를 흘렸기 때문에.
Because the young lamb, which is Jesus Christ, shed his blood for us.
나 이러이러한 많은 죄를 지었지만.
Even though I committed so and so sins.
내 죄가 어린 양 피만으로 충분히 씻어졌으니까.
But because by the blood of the young lamb, it sufficiently washed away my sins.
난 담대히 살 수가 있어.
Therefore, I can live boldly.
그러나 자기 정직하다고 정직한 걸 어제 피 안 바르면
But the people who are truthful they say that they don't put the blood
아니, 죽습니다.
Eventually they die.
이제 사탄은 우리를 많은 복잡한 생각을 해서
Satan he complicates our thoughts.
내가 십일조를 냈습니다.
And says, "Oh, I gave tithe."
내가 40일 금식 기도를 했습니다.
I did 40 days of fasting prayer.
내가 정말 충성을 했습니다.
I really devoted myself.
새벽 기도를 했습니다.
I did the early morning service.
그걸 가져가려고 하지 마십시오.
Do not try to take those things.
하나님은 어린 양의 피만 보십니다.
God only looks at the blood of the young lamb.
그 피는 우리를 대신 주신 예수님의 피를 가리킵니다.
And that blood represents the blood of Jesus who died for our sins.
여러분 죄를 깨끗이 씻을 수 있는 것은
What can wash away all of your sins clean?
우리를 위해 주신 예수의 피 외에 다른 건 아무것도 없습니다.
Other than the blood of Jesus, there is nothing else.
이해하십니까?
Understand, everyone.
그래서 여러분 우리는 좀 부족한 연약하고 허물이 많아도.
Therefore, even though we have a lot of flaws and we have a lot of lackings.
예수 피는 우리 모든 걸 사하니까.
But because the blood of Jesus washes away everything.
그래서 하나님 이런 이야기로 출애굽 유월절 이야기를 통해서.
And that's why through the book of Exodus, the story of Passover.
구원받는 정확한 길을 제시하고 있습니다.
Is directing us into the exact path of salvation.
저는 그 예수님 피가 내 모든 죄가 사하신 것을. 피로 내 모든 죄가 사해진 걸 믿습니다.
Everyone, I believe that by that blood, all of my sins have been washed.
그리고 그날부터 저는 이전 삶이 아니고 나의 첫 해의 첫 달이 되게 하고.
And so then, that's why it is no longer the old life, but it's saying that it will be the beginning of the months. It will be the first of the year.
지금까지 악된 삶이었지만.
Until then, all of my life was sinful.
어린 양이 죽은 내 죄를 사했기 때문에.
But because by the young lamb, the blood of the young lamb, he washed all my sins away.
해의 첫 달이다.
That's why from that year, that from that time, it is the first month. It's a new man.
그 전에 그 다 없애고.
All the things of the past are gone.
그럼 나 새 삶을 살게 했습니다.
I was born again. I'm able to live.
여러분들도 이제 우리 주 예수의 피로.
Everyone, now by the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ.
여러분 선한 일 한 거, 충성한 거, 기도한 거 모두 다 두고.
All of your zeal, all of the things which you devoted and the things you did well.
죄를 사는 우리가 선하다고 죄가 사해지는 게, 충성한 다 사해지는 게 아니고.
Just because we're devoted, just because we do good, doesn't mean that our sins are washed.
어린 양의 피만 우리 죄를 사할 수 있어.
Only by the young blood of the young lamb.
예수님 그 피를 흘리신 것은.
The reason why Jesus shed his blood.
우리 죄를 위하여 십자가에 못 박히셨기 때문입니다.
Because he was crucified for our sins.
우리 모든 죄값을 받으시. 받으시고
therefore he received all the punishment of our sins.
그 피는 우리 모든 죄가 씻어졌다는 증거.
And that is a testimony, a evidence that all of our sins have been washed.
내가 하나님 앞에 나가 생명을 얻을 수 있는 길은
And the only way for us to be able to receive eternal life
예수의 피 그 외에 아무것도 없습니다.
Other than the blood of Jesus, there is no other way.
예, 여러분 좀 선한 것도 그거 버리십시오.
Even if you have something good, throw it away.
남을 도와준 것도 버리고.
Even the things which you did to help others.
하늘로 갈 수 있는 건 유일한 예수님의 피밖에 없습니다.
The only way for us to go to heaven is by the blood of Jesus alone.
그래서 예수님은 피를 흘리고 십자가에 못 박혀 죽었어요.
That is why Jesus Christ was crucified on the cross, and He shed His blood for us.
그 피가 우리를 모든 죄에서 한 것입니다.
And that blood washed away our sins.
이제 그 안 죽으려면 문 앞에다 피를 설주와 임방에 바르.
And so if you don't want to die, then you better take that blood and put it upon the side and upper door posts.
저것들은 하도 죄 많이 지으니까 문에 피치라고 하지.
Ah, those people because they did so much evil, that's why they put the blood on the door posts.
하나님 그거 모를까봐 내가 얼마나 착하게 살았는데.
You know, just in case God didn't know, that's why I lived a good life.
난 착하게 살 피 안 치러도 돼.
I lived a good life, so I don't have to put blood.
그날 밤 깊은 밤에
And in the deep night,
통곡 소리 나는 거지.
All of a sudden there is wailing.
통곡 소리 막 납니다.
And there is sounds of wailing.
아이고 하나님도 무심하 이렇게 착하게 살 우리 아들 왜 죽였어?
Oh, our son was so good, but why did God kill him?
하나님 착한 사람 살린다 그랬습니다.
God never said that He's going to save the good.
피를 칠한 사람.
The people that have blood.
여러분 마음에 죄를 지은 기억들이 있을 겁니다.
Everyone, you have memories of your sin.
그러나 여러분이 뭘 피를 믿으십시오.
However, you must believe the blood.
예수님 흘린 그 피가
because that blood which Jesus shed, it
washed. 이 사실을 믿는 것입니다.
Believing that that washed away all my sins.
이걸 가르치기 위하여 성경 유월절 어린 양을 잡아서 피를 칠하는.
And that's why, in order to teach us this, he says, take the young lamb on the Passover.
피를 칠한 사람은 모두 다 산 것처럼.
Whoever takes the blood, they will live.
십자가 예수의 피로 내 죄가 사했다 믿는 사람은
Those who believe that through the blood of Jesus Christ on the cross washed away my sins.
멸망치 않고
They will not be destroyed.
영생을 얻습니다.
But have everlasting life.
기도하겠습니다.
Let us pray.
하나님 거룩하신 아버지 앞에 감사합니다.
Our holy Father God, we thank you.
우리는 성경을 잘 몰라서 정말 이런 여러 가지 선한 걸 가지고 하나님 나가려고 했습니다.
Because we did not know about the Lord, that's why we tried to take all these.
우리 하나님 설 수 있는 것은 어린 양 된 예수의 피밖에 없습니다.
The only way for us to stand before the Lord is by the young Lamb of Jesus Christ.
십자가 흘린 예수님의 피는 우리 모든 죄 사하기에 부족함이 없었습니다.
The blood which you shed upon the cross, Lord, it is not lacking at all to wash away our sins.
주는 피를 흘리며 십자가에 못 박이 죽으시 우리 죄 사하신 주님께 감사합니다.
We truly thank the Lord who was crucified on the cross and shed His blood to wash away our sins.
그 피로 우리 모든 죄가 씻어졌습니다.
Through that blood, He washed away all of our sins.
의롭습니다.
We are righteous.
거룩합니다.
We are holy.
감사합니다.
We are thankful.
이런 믿음을 주옵소서.
Please give us this faith.
우리 모두에게 은혜를 베풀소서.
We ask that You may bestow grace upon all of us.
예수님 이름으로 기도드립니다.
In Jesus' name, I pray.
Amen.
Amen.
여러분 감사합니다.
Thank you, everyone.
네, 감사합니다. 이번 성경 세미나는 저녁으로 3일 동안 이어지겠습니다.
Our Bible seminar will continue for the, just in the evenings for 3 days.
네, 감사합니다. 내일 저녁에 또 뵙겠습니다.
And so we thank you. We'll see you once again
네,
tomorrow evening.
합창단의 찬양으로 마무리하겠습니다.
And we will close with the praise of the Gracias Choir.